Hello class, hope everybody are fine. Yes, we are studying the lesson Conservation of Plants and Animals. In the previous class, we have learned about deforestation, biosphere reserve, flora and fauna, endemic species and wildlife sanctuary. So, shall we continue the lesson? Okay, you all have learned that Paheli and Bujo along with their classmates and with Professor Ahmed and Madhav ji were studying the Panchmari Biosphere Reserve. So they have studied and now they are in the National Park. Which is that National Park? Satpura National Park. Let's see what happens and what they will learn in that forest or National Park. Okay. Children are now eager to go to Satpura National Park. Madhavji tells them that these reserves are large and diverse enough to protect whole sets of ecosystem. And in case of this Satpura National Park, there are wide varieties of flora and fauna, landscapes and historical objects in that area. And these national parks preserve these landscapes and historical objects, flora and fauna of that area. What do you mean by historical objects? An object surviving from an earlier time is said to be historical objects. Landscapes means it is the visible feature of an area, including all the land areas is said to be landscapes. Okay? Yes. Satpura National Park is the first reserve forest of India. Which is the first reserve forest of India? Satpura National Park is the first reserve forest of India. And in the Satpura National Park, teak, Indian teak is found. And there are more than 100 national parks in India. One more feature of this reserve area is rock shelters. Rock shelters are found inside Satpura National Park. So it gives us the evidence that prehistorical human life was there in these jungles. Humans used to live in these jungles and they used to take the shelter in the caves of rocks. So, rock paintings are found in these shelters and you all know that the early man used to converse to each other by drawing the pictures in the wall. See, the pictures of men fighting, hunting, dancing and playing musical instruments were depicted in these paintings. So, other men or women also used to understand from the paintings. From the wall. Many tribals still live in this area. Even now we can see many tribal people living in this forest. As children move ahead, they see a board with Satpura Tiger Reserve. So Madhavji explains that Project Tiger was launched by the government in order to protect the tigers in the country. What is the feature of Project Tiger? What is the objective of Project Tiger? In order to protect the tigers, they launched Project Tiger. Who launched? The government launched Tiger Project or Project Tiger in order to protect the tigers of the country. The objective of this project was to ensure the survival and maintenance of the tiger population in the country. In order to maintain the population of the tigers, in order to take care of the tigers, Project Tiger was launched by the government. Tiger is one of the species which are slowly disappearing from our forest. You all know that the population of tiger is very less. Very few tigers are seen in the forest. But in case of Satpura Tiger Reserve, we can say that there is significant increase in the population of tigers. You know why? Because there is special care for the tigers. Tigers are taken care and it is protected. Once upon a time, animals like lions, elephants, wild buffaloes and barasinga were also found in Satpura National Park. But now we can see many endangered animals. What do you mean by endangered animals? Those animals which are decreasing or which are diminishing to a level that one day might come where no more such animals will be there, or animals whose number are diminishing to a level that they might face extinction is known as endangered animals. One day might come where there will be no such animals at all in the forest. Those type of animals are known as endangered animals. For example, dinosaur once lived in earth, but now it cannot be seen anywhere. So dinosaur has become extinct a long time ago. Survival of endangered animals has become difficult because of the disturbance in their natural habitat. Professor Ahmed tells the children that in order to protect the plants and animals, strict rules must be imposed in all national parks. Mainly, these human activities must be prohibited. Human activities such as grazing, poaching, hunting, capturing the animals, or collection of firewood or medicinal plants must not be allowed, so that plants and animals will be safe in their habitat. Madhavji tells Paheli that even the small animals are much more in danger of becoming extinct than the bigger animals. You know why? Because you might have observed, whenever we see some frogs or lizards or bats, we just kill them. No, children? Yes. Human beings will kill the small animals like frogs, lizards, bats, owls ruthlessly without realizing that they are very important in the ecosystem. So one thing we have to remember that these small animals are also very important. They have their own food chain and food webs. So about the food webs, you have studied in your previous class, that is in 7th standard, isn't it, children? So each animal or each organism is very important in the ecosystem or in the nature. We must not harm the animals or the organisms. By killing them, we are harming ourselves. Indirectly, we are harming ourselves. They might be small in size. The animals might be small in size, but their role in the ecosystem is very high, or it cannot be ignored, because they form part of food chains and food webs. What do you mean by ecosystem? An ecosystem is made up of plants, animals and microorganisms in an area, along with non-living components also. Which are the non-living components? Climate, soil, river deltas, weather, all these are the non-living abiotic components. So in an ecosystem, we see both living and non-living components, which are very much important for the survival of all. Red data book. So Professor Ahmed explains about red data book to the children. What is red data book? It is a source book which has a record of all the endangered animals and plants. What it has got? It will have a record of the endangered animals and plants in it. Red Data Book is maintained internationally by an organization. Even India also maintains Red Data Book for plants and animals found in India. All the plants and animals, almost all the plants and animals found in India are recorded in Red Data Book. Migration. The excursion party then enters deeper into the forest under the guidance of Madhavji. They sit near the Tawa reservoir to relax for some time. What happened now? All the children along with Professor Ahmed and Madhavji were very tired of studying the feature of the reserve or the forest area. So they wanted to take rest. Then they sat near Tawa reservoir in order to relax for some time. By then, Paheli saw some of the birds near the river. So, she had many questions in her mind and Madhavji explains or clears her doubts. Madhavji tells the children that those birds were migratory birds and they actually did not belong to this forest, but they had come from some other parts of the world. Migratory birds fly to faraway areas every year during a particular time because of the climatic changes. It may be because of cold climate changes. Why do they fly? Because to lay eggs. As the weather in their natural habitat becomes very cold and inhospitable, the migratory birds fly to some other place. Birds who cover long distance to reach another land are known as migratory birds. Especially to survive in the cold climatic conditions, birds fly to thousands of kilometers far to some other place, and after the season gets over, after the season, again, they come back to their original place. Recycling of paper. Professor Ahmed draws attention of the children to another cause of deforestation. In the beginning of the lesson only, we have studied about the deforestation effects and causes and consequences also. Is that in children? Yes. So, one more cause of deforestation is manufacturing of paper. So it takes 17 full grown trees to make 1 ton of paper. You need 17 big trees or full grown trees in order to make 1 ton of paper. Then you see or imagine the condition of the trees, how much trees will be cut in a year. Therefore, we should save paper. Professor Ahmed also tells that paper can be recycled 5 to 7 times for use. One more important thing is that paper can be recycled. We can use the same paper 5 to 7 times. If each student saves at least 1 sheet of paper in a day, we can save many trees in a year. We should save, reuse used paper and recycle it. It is very important to reuse the paper, save the paper and recycle the paper so that we can save the trees. Not only saving the trees, one more thing is that we can also save energy and water needed for the manufacturing paper. One more thing is that the amount of harmful chemicals used in the paper making or paper manufacturing will also be reduced. So always keep in mind that we have to use the paper again and again. We have to reuse it, we have to recycle it, and we have to save paper so that we can save the trees and we can save the energy and water needed for the manufacturing paper, and we can decrease the amount of harmful chemicals used in the manufacturing paper. Reforestation. Professor Ahmed suggests that the answer to deforestation is reforestation. How can we get back the forest? It is by reforestation. Reforestation means restocking of the destroyed forest by planting new trees. The planted trees should generally be of the same species which were found in the forest or in that forest. We should plant at least as many trees as we cut. So if we cut the trees, again we have to plant new trees or new plants or saplings, and then we have to look after it also so that it grows into a new tree. Reforestation can take place naturally also. How is it? If the deforested area is left as it is without the disturbance of human beings and animals, then it grows into a new forest. It automatically or naturally get converted into a forest area. All of you know that we human beings have already caused tremendous damage to our forest. No, children, forest lands are cut and it is converted into agricultural lands, or for the building purpose it is cut. So what we have to do is we have to retain our green wealth for future generations. Plantation of more trees is the only option. We have to plant more trees. We have to look after the green plants. We have to maintain green wealth for future generation. You all know that plants are very important in nature. Plants are the producers. If plants are there, then all the organisms will survive, because plants will maintain the oxygen level in the atmosphere also. And oxygen is very much necessary for all the living beings. So we must maintain the green wealth of our nature, of our earth. Professor Ahmed told them that in India we have the Forest Conservation Act. So this act is aimed at preservation and conservation of natural forest and meeting the basic needs of the people living in or near the forest. So this Forest Conservation Act will look after the basic needs of the people living in and around the forest. At the same time, it will conserve and preserve the natural forests. This is all about the lesson. Now, what happened? After some rest, Madhavji asks the children to start heading back, because it is not advisable to stay in the jungle after sunset. You all know that in the jungle, wild animals will be there. So it is not at all safe for us to be there in the forest after sunset. We have to return back from the forest soon, before the sun sets. On getting back, Professor Ahmed and the children thanked Madhavji for guiding them through this exciting experience. So, did you all come to know about the different forest treasures or the flora and fauna and reservoirs there? Yes.